Guys, and welcome back to the channel. For quite some time I was having some old faulty LED bulb lying around on my bench. So in this video, let's try to make something nice out of them instead of throwing them in the bin or worse. As you can see here, I got two type of old LED bulb. Two of them are with the base B22 and the other two are with the screw base. The two bulb with the base B22 seems to not be working at all, but the other two with the screw base work just fine. But for this video I'll be working on all four of them. But first with those two LED bulb which has the screw base, due to the reason it will be more easily to adapt them to the project. The first step was obviously to take one bulb apart, and after removing its top cover we are gladded by a simple LED array, just 5 LED, well, how convenient. And under we have a simple capacitor dropper circuit, and after removing everything from inside and just leaving the bare case to work with it, the board from the LED will be used for a different project which I may do in the nearly future. The first project will be a simple LED chaser, so call it a stable multivibrator. The circuit looks like this on breadboard. Schematic is now in front of you. How the circuit is working is quite simple, let me explain it. The unstable multivibrator is another type of cross-coupled transistor switching that has no stable output, meaning that the state as it's charged from one state to another state will oscillate at all the time. The unstable circuit consists of three or more switching transistors, a cross-coupled feedback network based on resistor, and three or more time delay capacitors, which will allow the oscillation between the two states with no need for external triggering for a change in the state. By adding a simple variable resistor in series with the base resistor, we can vary the running frequency of the oscillator circuit. And after I got all the required components, before I start putting the circuit together, we have to test the LED to make sure they are good. And for that I'll be using this small LED testing board. First it is the blue, then the red, then the green. So all the LED are working. Little things, big difference. After I start soldering them to one another, first I have made the LED array for the three colors, red, green and blue. And then I start making the rest of the circuit according to the schematic. And after some time we have this Frankenstein of the circuit. And after I set my power bench supply to around 5 volts, I have connected the circuit and it seems to work just fine. Now with the help of the variable resistor we can adjust the speed on which the LED are going in and out. Now something to mention, by increasing the voltage you can see that the speed at which the LED is changing from one state to another has increased. And as well, if you are decreasing the voltage you will have to readjust it again. Now let's go back to the bottom side of the bulb, and with the help of a 8mm drill bit the hole was done and we can do a test fit of the plug. Niche, huh? Then I have added few more LEDs to the circuit to increase its overall light emitting capability. I will be configuring mine for 12 volts, but you can configure yours as you wish. And after making the last touches to the LED bulb, the project was done. It looks like an ordinary LED bulb, but now let's turn the light and enjoy some cool RGB color. Okay, enough with that, let's move on to the next project, which will be a simple audio reactive LED. The circuit looks like this on breadboard. The schematic is now in front of you. How the circuit is working is quite simple, let me explain it as well. At the core of the circuit we got two 2N5551 NPN transistor. The Q1 is responsible to preamplify the signal coming from the condensator microphone, which picks up the sound signal and converts it into a voltage level. These voltage signals are further fed in the RC filter or high pass filter, which is set by the R2 and C1. And after the signal got preamplified, the Q2 will be modulating the output, as you can see on the oscilloscope. The circuit in a nutshell is just a simple LED flasher. After that I start testing all the 3 Piranha LED which I will be using for this project. And after I have gathered all the required components, I have connected them in the mid-air using some old components leads, a jumper and bridge connection. And after a while we got our second Frankenstein circuit ready to be tested. And after connecting it to a 12 volt supply, it seems that the circuit works as it should. Here it is a live demonstration. The sensitivity of it can be decreased or increased by the small tripod RP1. As well, here is how it's looking on the oscilloscope. Then I did the same for the LED bulb, which was first to remove its top cap, then the board which I will be holding on, and as well the pin from the bottom side. And after we can prepare the base for the LED by using first a 6mm drill bit for the power jack, then I follow that up by using a 8mm drill bit for drilling the two remaining holes required for this project. And then I have took it a 10mm drill bit to enlarge the hole for our condensator microphone. After that I filled the entire LED base with hot glue to be sure that the parts are properly secured in place. And after putting back the top cap we can test it. Here it is, a live demonstration about the circuit operation. Now if you are planning to repeat this project, I recommend you to make few more of them. Like that you'll be getting a small disco setup in your house. And let's move on to the last project for today. This one is quite simple, the circuit looks like this on breadboard. The circuit function is simple, this is a simple white temperature balancing consisting of two rows of LED, in this case a set of 4 cold white LED and a solar row of warm white LED. The circuit is now in front of you. How the circuit is working is quite simple, let me explain it. At the core of the circuit you got a pair of NPN transistors, which are controlled by a simple variable resistor, so called potentiometer. By using the variable resistor RP1, we can adjust the light color temperature. For a smooth transition, I recommend you to use a potentiometer no bigger than 10 kΩ. Like that you can ensure a smooth transition from one color to another. The two NPN RFZ44N are normally open all the time by the help of a pull-up resistor of around 2.2 kΩ. With the help of the 5 kΩ potentiometer, they will form a simple voltage divider, which in resolve will allow the transistor to be fully on or fully off. Let's prepare the LED case and after take it apart, we can salvage the part from it. We can start assembling the circuit, but first we have to test the 8 LED for this project. First will be the white cold LED, then the warm white LED. Now after gathering all the required components, I start connecting them with the midair like in the previous two circuits, starting first with the two rows of LED, and then proceed further with the rest of the circuit assembling. And after I got my number 3 Frankenstein circuit, and after testing it, it worked as it should. Now onto the case, the G22 base is quite hard to adapt it to this project, but still it can be done. After enlarging the two holes using a 6.5mm drill bit, I followed that up with a 8mm drill bit for the power jack, and as well for the small variable potentiometer. And after that I have hot glued the circuit inside and we are ready to test it. As you can see the circuit works great and it can be easily adjusted with the help of the variable potentiometer. Now here is a simple working presentation of all three projects I have showed in this video. Which one do you think is more interesting? Leave your thoughts down in the comment section. The video has now come to an end. This was the first video from the new video series I tried to make it called What You Can Do From. Or maybe you got a suggestion about the name of this video series. Now detail about today's video can be found in the video description. I hope you find this video interesting and I hope I will see you all in the next video. Till then, have a nice day and thank you very much for watching. See ya!